Ukraine says Russia has cut off all gas supplies in a major escalation of the dispute between these two nations. Russia's state-owned Gazprom says Ukraine now has to pay upfront for its gas supplies. The move comes as Kiev failed to settle its huge debt. Gazprom had asked Ukraine to pay some $1.95 billion of the $4.5 billion it says it is owed. But Moscow said it would continue to supply gas to Europe for the meantime. For more on this story, let's cross now to London to speak to Dr. Andrew Foxall, a Russia specialist from the Henry Jackson Society. Thank you very much for being with us. Now, the West has seen these gas talks as a sort of gauge of Russian leader Vladimir Putin's willingness to compromise. So why did Russia pull the plug at this point?
You're quite right. I think Western countries saw the discussions that were taking place and which ultimately, of course, ended on Monday as a sign of whether or not Russia and President Vladimir Putin would, in a sense, make an effort to de-escalate the Ukraine crisis or try to reduce the pressure on the Ukrainian authorities. Clearly that hasn't been the case. In terms of quite why the dispute took place, which I think it really ought to be said represents the culmination of months of pressure that Moscow has put on Kiev, and opens up a new dimension in a sense of the conflict, which at the moment shows no sign of ending. Quite why the discussions took place on Monday. Well, you know, in truth, they did end on Monday, but this was the latest in a number of deadlines that Russia had given Ukraine to pay off its gas debts, or indeed to agree to a new formula, effectively, by which Ukraine would pay Russia for its gas supply.
Now, Ukraine sees these talks as a way of Moscow manipulating the situation in their favour, don't they?
They certainly do. It's long been thought that Russia uses its supply of oil and gas to Europe through Ukraine, but also through Belarus and a number of other Eastern European countries, as tools effectively of geopolitical manipulation. And I think in a sense that is true where Ukraine is concerned. If one looks at the origins of the current gas dispute, in April, what happened was Russia increased or attempted to increase the price that Ukraine pays for its gas by 80%. Clearly, the move was an attempt to increase the pressure on the interim government in Ukraine, and has thus continued to increase the pressure on the newly elected President Petro Poroshenko.
What immediate impact will this decision have? Because at the moment we're heading into summer, but a few months down the track, obviously, winter will be approaching, mm-hmm. and it will be then a very different story, won't it?
Mm-hmm. You're quite right. This is, in a sense, not the first gas dispute between Russia and Ukraine. There were two previous ones, the first in 2006 and the second in 2009. In contrast to the current dispute, both of the earlier disputes took place at the height of winter. We're currently at the height of summer. The impact of this dispute will therefore be in the medium term rather than the short term. Thinking about those impacts, after a relatively mild winter, European reserves of gas are relatively high. There has been an indication that some of Ukraine's Eastern European neighbours, not least Slovakia, would look to reverse their supply back to Ukraine. So the impact will be in the medium term if a resolution to this dispute cannot be solved before winter.
But it certainly doesn't bode well in general for the crisis in Ukraine, does it?
Not at all. Although I think the implications of the dispute are far wider than Ukraine's borders itself. The European Union, of course, gets over roughly 30% of its gas from Russia, of which 15% is transited across the Ukraine. A number of Eastern and Central European countries are heavily dependent on Russia for their gas supply. But again, this will be felt in the medium term rather than the short term.
So, is there a danger, Dr. Foxall, that Moscow could shut off those supplies as well to Europe?
There isn't. At the moment, what Moscow is saying that it has simply reduced the flow of gas through Ukraine by the amount of gas that Ukraine buys itself, which is to say that the flow of gas through Ukraine continues for Eastern European and Central European markets. In past disputes, Russia has accused Ukraine of, in effect, siphoning off some of that flow for its own use. At the moment, there isn't an immediate danger that we will see a knock-on impact with regards to the flow of gas into East and Central Europe, though, of course, if the dispute isn't solved before winter, we could well see that.
Dr. Foxall, I'm afraid we're going to have to leave it there. Thank you so much for your time.